Cary Grant and Tori are tackling the tall tale that a trance is your chance for a hot-cold crossing.
Yeah!
See, that wasn't so bad.
But so far, the numbers predict that anyone can do it burn-free. However, there's only one way to find out for sure. So a hop, step, and a jump cut later.
Does this seem like a stupid idea now?
No.
We've had a lot stupider ideas than this.
It's the moment we, if not Cary Grant and Tori, have all been waiting for.
All right, those coals are all red hot. You guys ready?
There's no turning back now.
Oh, are you nervous at all?
No.
A little.
All right.
After a few moments to psych herself up, Carrie's the first onto the foot fryer. Cue the dramatic music.
It's not totally not hot.
Despite her levels of adrenaline shooting off the scale, Cary makes it across safely and finds her feet unfried.
It's doable. That's doable.
Next up for their tiptoe into trepidation is Grant.
Yeah, Grant!
And cool as a cucumber, he catwalks over the coals.
Very graceful!
There we go. A little hotter than I expected, but I think I made it.
Which just leaves Tori. And true to form, he steps up and charges straight in.
Here we go.
Before breezing across.
It's not that bad at all. I thought it was gonna be a lot worse than that. It looks way worse than it is. It's really not that bad. It's the mental part that messes with you the most. As soon as I stepped on it, it really wasn't that bad. In fact, I didn't even feel it. I had to walk back one more time just to see whether or not they were hot.
That was so crazy. But you know what? The worst part was what was going on in your head. The physical wasn't so bad.
Yeah, there is not any amount of drumming or chanting that would have made me walk on that coal. But the physics was there. That's what got me through the first step.
You know what? I'm not gonna lie. It was hot out there, but not hot enough to burn us.
All right, so this one's looking busted.
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 All right, let's try gasoline-soaked socks next.
Woo!
It seems it's physics that keep your feet from being flame-grilled and not mind over matter. Or is it? What about a mind unprepared? A mind unsullied by the certainty of science?
That was gonna be a lot worse than that.
To find out, let's segue to the next day.
What are you cooking?
We're gonna be cooking, well, at the bottom of your feet.
We're looking at the science of firewalking.
Firewalking! Awesome!
Apparently, Adam would walk over hot coals to walk over hot coals.
We're all set up. Adam just got here, but we haven't lit the fire yet. I want to light it in front of him so he sees how hot this fire gets. So that starts playing on his mind.
One thing to think intellectually that I've always wanted to walk on fire. It's quite another to feel the heat of 2,000 some odd degrees at my back.
So Adam's ready for his trial by fire.
You can do it.
And remember, before Cary Grant and Tori took their first hot step, they knew they wouldn't get burned.
You gotta tell your feet.
My heart rate just went up a bit. Okay.
But Adam knows nothing about the data and the technique of stepping lightly. Will he get across unscathed, or will those red-hot coals fry his feet?
Ah!
Ah, yes. Apparently so.
Woo! Wow! That hurt a lot.
Ow was going through my head. As I did it, walk, 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 this isn't so bad. Holy crap, this is pretty bad. Ah! Like that. That's about the thought process.
So it seems that it does matter what's in your mind. But only insofar as knowledge about technique and preparation go.
With no prep at all, I think I made a classic mistake of speeding up and digging my feet into the coals more.
Yep, Adam's hard marching method meant some of the coals stuck to his feet, giving them more time to conduct their heat.
Ah!